The first peoples in the Americas. The Americas, a vast and diverse landmass, once untouched by human feet. But who were the first people to step onto these lands? And how did they reach the American continent? Their journey would have been one of immense challenges, adversity, and adventure. Upon arrival, they would have faced towering beasts unlike anything they had encountered before. For these colossal creatures, it would have likewise been their first encounter with humans. The delicate balance between predator and prey would be transformed, signaling the start of a new era of intense adaptation. As they ventured into this untamed world, the first peoples braved a harsh and unforgiving landscape, shaped by the last glacial period. But when exactly did the first peoples in the Americas arrive? Determining the timeline is a puzzle we can begin piecing together by examining archaeology, genetics, and anthropology. Let us start in 1929, when 19-year-old amateur archaeologist Ridgely Whiteman uncovered the first Clovis points near the town of Clovis, New Mexico. These beautifully fluted stone tools, found alongside the remains of extinct Ice Age animals, were like nothing seen before, capturing the imagination of researchers. The discovery of Clovis points led to the Clovis first theory, which dominated the field for much of the 20th century. This theory proposed that the makers of these distinctive tools were the first people to arrive in the Americas around 13,000 years ago. For years, this was considered the definitive narrative, until a groundbreaking discovery in 1975 near Monte Verde, Chile, which challenged everything. Monte Verde's structures and well-preserved artifacts, dating to more than 14,500 years ago, demonstrate that humans were in the Americas earlier than Clovis, forcing archaeologists to rethink the timeline of the first migrations. However, it took over two decades for scientists to fully accept the significance of this site as they debated the accuracy of these findings. It was not until 1997 when a group of leading archaeologists visited the Monte Verde site and reviewed the evidence that the findings gained wider acceptance. Around this time, another controversial site was being excavated, the Meadowcroft Rock Shelter in Pennsylvania. Meadowcroft Rock Shelter has yielded thousands of artifacts, including stone tools, animal bones, and plant remains in layers dated between 16 and 19,000 years ago. And while skeptics of these sites continue to question the evidence, these findings gave other archaeologists confidence to dig in the layers below the 13,000-year-old strata. And as they dug deeper, the world was shocked at what began to be unearthed and dates in which they came from. Sites like Cactus Hill in Virginia, the Buttermilk Creek Complex in Texas, Paisley Caves in Oregon, and too many more to name them all. Archaeologists also began reevaluating and re-corroborating old evidence, such as the Manus mastodon site, where in 1977 in Washington State, a mastodon rib was found that had a human-made spear tip embedded in it. In 2011, the Center of the Study of the First Americans reviewed this evidence and found that the spear point was made by humans and it was dated to 13,800 years ago. The Bluefish Caves in Alaska were first excavated in 1977. They yielded artifacts dating to 24,000 years ago. This was mostly dismissed, as it was too controversial and didn't fit the Clovis first theory. However, it was reevaluated in 2017 and reconfirmed to be 24,000 years old. Dates older than 20,000 years ago have been revealed from other sites and artifacts. In 2009, fossilized human footprints were discovered in White Sands National Park in New Mexico. In 2021, these footprints were radiocarbon dated to 21 to 23,000 years ago, based on seeds found in the sediment layers. These results were upheld in 2023 through radiocarbon dating of pollen and optically stimulated luminescence dating of quartz grains. Also in 2023, archaeologists discovered three pendants in Brazil made by humans from giant sloth bones. These sloth bones were dated to 25 to 27,000 years ago from the sediment layers that they were discovered in. And there are other more controversial sites like Serra da Capivara, Old Crow Flats, Chickiweet Cave, and Pedra Furada that span a date range of 22 to 48,000 years ago. With all this mounting evidence, it became very clear that while the Clovis culture was very interesting, they were not the first peoples in America. People had actually been living in America thousands, even tens of thousands of years before the Clovis culture. But where did they come from? And how did they get here? An early theory of how humans migrated to the American continent is the Bering Land Bridge theory. This theory proposes that early humans migrated from Asia to North America by crossing a land bridge that once connected present-day Siberia and Alaska during the Ice Age. This land bridge, known as Bering, was exposed during periods of glaciation when global sea levels dropped due to the large amounts of water locked in ice sheets. Bering, a vast region, stretched hundreds of miles across the Bering Strait and provided a route for both humans and animals to move between the continents. This landmass would rise and fall in cycles of glacial and interglacial periods. During glaciations, when large amounts of Earth's water were trapped in ice sheets, sea levels would drop, exposing the land bridge. This allowed animals and humans to migrate between Asia and North America. During interglacial periods, like the one we are in now, when the ice sheets melted, sea levels would rise, submerging Bering beneath the Bering Strait. From 20 core samples taken from the Bering Sea in 1985, carbon dating of the plants, insect, and animal remains found in the samples indicate it was last above water around 12,900 years ago. During the last glacial maximum, 20 to 26,000 years ago, Canada was largely impassable for early human migration due to the presence of massive ice sheets. Two main ice sheets, the Laurentide Ice Sheet and the Cordilleran Ice Sheet, covered most of present-day Canada and parts of the northern United States, forming an almost continuous barrier of ice that stretched from the Atlantic to the Pacific. These ice sheets were up to several kilometers thick and covered much of North America, effectively blocking any overland routes between Alaska and the lower regions of the continent. The sheer size and cold temperatures of these glaciers made it impossible for humans or animals to cross them. This impassable barrier forced early humans to wait until the ice sheets began to melt and retreat. As the glaciers receded, they created an ice-free corridor between the two massive ice sheets running roughly along the eastern Rocky Mountains. This corridor eventually became passable, allowing humans and animals to move southward into what is now the continental United States. In a 2022 study of the ice-free corridor, it was found that the ice sheet would have been impassable until about 13,800 years ago. However, now that we know humans arrived in the Americas much earlier, researchers have had to reconsider the route they may have taken. This led to a new theory, called the coastal migration theory. This theory proposes that the first humans to arrive in the Americas did so by following the Pacific coastline rather than through the ice-free corridor. According to this theory, early humans may have traveled in small boats or along shorelines from Northeast Asia, around the edge of the glaciers, and down the Pacific coast of North America. The theory claims this coastal migration would have occurred around 15 to 20,000 years ago, shortly after the last glacial maximum, when the interior of North America was blocked by massive ice sheets, making the coastal route a more viable path for reaching new lands. While the coastal migration theory has strong support, several challenges still remain, particularly the lack of early coastal archaeological sites and physical evidence of seafaring technology. The discovery of the double helix structure of DNA in 1953, along with the unraveling of the genetic code in the 1960s, revolutionized biology and laid the groundwork for a new field of genetic research. In 1968, the remains of a Paleo-Indian male child were discovered in south-central Montana. The burial site contained hundreds of stone tools and Clovis points, many of which were covered in red ochre. The remains were dated to approximately 12,900 years ago. The child is known as Anzik I, named after the family who owned the ranch where the remains were discovered. By the 1980s, scientists began using the advances in genetics to trace human migrations, offering a powerful new tool to study how ancient populations moved and interacted across the globe. In 2014, a team of researchers from the United States and Europe conducted paleogenetic analysis of the remains of Anzik I. These analyses revealed that the individual was closely related to Native Americans in Central and South America. The infant was also related to persons from Siberia and Central Asia, supporting the theory that the peopling of the Americas occurred from Asia across the Bering Strait. In the 1920s, the remains of a child were found near Lake Baikal, in south-central Siberia, at what is now known as the Malta-Burat site. These remains were not extensively studied until decades later, when the remains were determined to be 24,000 years old. A genetic analysis published in 2013 showed that this individual shared a genetic connection with Native Americans. These discoveries show that the ancestors of Native Americans were part of a broader population in northeastern Asia and Siberia before they crossed the Bering Land Bridge into the Americas. Other genetic studies have solidified this connection, showing that modern Native Americans share significant ancestry with ancient Siberian groups. The Urantia Book, published in 1955, presents a narrative that our recent discoveries now appear to be aligning with. This narrative explains that the first peoples in America crossed the Bering Sea land bridge around 85,000 years ago. Shortly after, the land bridge sank, and never again did they cross back into the Asian continent. There were 11 tribes in all, numbering about 7,000 men, women, and children. They were accompanied by three small groups that never fully fraternized with the 11 tribes. These three groups made their way down to Mexico and South America. On the North American continent, these people would thus be isolated until a chance meeting between a Native American tribe and a lone Inuit group on the southeastern shores of the Hudson Bay around 5,000 years ago. They found it difficult to communicate, but soon after began to intermarry. This would be the only contact these people would have with the outside world on the North American continent until the arrival of the white man 1,000 years ago. The Urantia papers also explain that 132 Andites left Japan in a fleet of small boats and island hopped all the way to South America, where they also intermarried with the first peoples living there. This happened sometime between 10,000 and 14,000 years ago. As we stand on the edge of what we know about the first peoples in the Americas, we can't help but marvel at the incredible discoveries still waiting to be uncovered. With every advancement in archaeology, genetics, and anthropology, we discover new pieces of an ancient puzzle, drawing us closer to understanding the true origins and journeys of the earliest Americans. What new stories are buried beneath the soil or hidden in ancient DNA? What will new technologies reveal about the lives, struggles, and triumphs of those who came before us? Each discovery, no matter how small, has the potential to rewrite chapters of human history and reshape our understanding of where we came from. Thanks for watching.